With the temperature only just on freezing point and high humidity, the snow is going to be heavy for the final alpine skiing event of the Vancouver Olympics, the men's slalom. Two runs to discover the master of technique. And the first to make his mark, 30-year-old Ivica KOSTELIC. The Croatian, looking for his second medal of the Games, he'd already picked up silver in the Super Combined. And KOSTELIC coming home to set a new fastest time, nearly half a second quicker than Sylvain Zurbriggen of Switzerland. This was Andre MYHRER, a tall man, 1.89 m, seeking to become the first Swede to make the podium since Ingmar Stenmark back in 1980. 4 years earlier in Turin, he just missed out, finishing in fourth place. Now, here in Canada, coming towards the bottom, MYHRER 4/5 of a second off the pace on run number one. Now from Italy, Giuliano RAZZOLI. For him, the man to emulate was Alberto Tomba, who'd won the gold in Calgary 22 years earlier. RAZZOLI making it look almost effortless. He wasn't one of the favorites, but he was about to make everyone sit up and take notice. Quicker than KOSTELIC by 0.43, and joy for the Italian. RAZZOLI was clearly in fine form. He'd recently won a World Cup race in Zagreb, and now he was in pole position on the Olympic course in Canada. The standings after run number one, RAZZOLI ahead of Mitja Valančić and Benjamin Reich in third place. So to run number two, and MYHRER about to go again. He was lying in just 10th position, and he needed something miraculous to get amongst the medals. But this second run would certainly be much smoother than the first. MYHRER had started with an advantage of half a second over Cousineau of Canada, and the gap was widening all the time. Just a slight wobble towards the bottom, but Andre MYHRER crossed the finish line almost a second to the good. A terrific run from the 27-year-old Swede. Then, Ivica KOSTELIC with a cushion of 2/3 of a second over MYHRER. On the early part of the course, KOSTELIC wasn't as fast as the Swede, and that cushion was getting smaller. But the Croatian number one was making no mistakes and produced a solid enough run to put him ahead by just over a quarter of a second. So KOSTELIC in the lead. And then with both Reich and Valančić failing to keep KOSTELIC at bay, there was only one man left. And that man was Giuliano RAZZOLI, the Italian with just over half a second in hand from the first run. And RAZZOLI maintaining that lead at the intermediate check. But he was slower on the lower section. Would he be fast enough to take the gold? Coming down towards the finish, RAZZOLI over the line and inside the tie by 1/16 of a second. And Giuliano RAZZOLI had done what his hero Alberto Tomba had done more than two decades before. An unexpected Olympic gold medal for the 25-year-old. And down at the bottom of the course, Tomba, his friend and mentor, was there to see it all happen. Ivica KOSTELIC picked up his second silver medal, with MYHRER taking the bronze to make up for his disappointment of his fourth place finish 4 years earlier. This time it was Reich, the defending champion, who finished fourth, which meant that the Austrian men's team went home without an alpine medal for the first time since 1936. Yeah. And so, the last of the Vancouver Alpine titles going to the Italian Giuliano RAZZOLI, finally stepping out of the shadow of his number one supporter, Alberto Tomba.